Okay, Castlevania freaks and Halloween lovers and Bloodborne lovers. This is my continuation of my Trevor Belmont from Castlevania with Love in Blood. Now, for those they don't know the series and they don't even have a clue, this character is one of my dearest video game related epic characters of all time, you know, since the very old Nintendo NES era, and one of my favorite heroes from the lore of Castlevania. So this playthrough has been always pretty much a tribute to these characters and the Belmont clan. But this is a remake of my original playthrough that I did way back. Hey, hi. Werewolf. Be a bad boy, werewolf. Yeah, I already did my original playthrough in this game. It was a, you know, sort of a cosplay reference to this character, and this is my second time I am doing this series, and the reason for that is because I thought that my first one, it was, you know, way too choppy and way too, I don't know, it was kind of made in a little bit poor way. I wasn't too satisfied with the final result. So we can sneak on this guy. Damn it. He even flinched from the attack. So I think I did manage to do the whole game without dying once in that original playthrough. If you're interested to see it, it's somewhere out there in my channel. Look for the whole playlist. But after I rewatched it, I was like, you know what, I really want to remake the series and make it better. And more, you know, lengthy, a little bit more in depth. One of those big monsters here. Creepy bastards. Some of the most creepiest enemies in this game. So they can hit you extremely hard, so you have to be really careful not get hit by them. Also, because it's Halloween, I was like, I had to do some kind of special video that, you know, put me in that Halloween mood, because Halloween has been my all-time favorite holiday, and honestly, one of the few human-made holidays that I ever really care. I think the next one has to be Mother's Day. Well, you know, I love mothers, so... But Halloween... Oh, yeah. I don't know, to me, Halloween is every single day of my life, you know? When you are a person that are into classic horror, into gothic stuff, you know, Halloween... is that day for you. just gonna take this path over here. Let's see. You sneaky gremlin. Just look at you. That jump that he took, man. I might let one of these guys kill me in another episode just to show one cutscene that I never show in my playthroughs, cause I never let these fools kill me, so... If they kill you, they will take you to a special area. You don't have to be killed by them to reach the area, but it will show a unique cutscene and it will show other, you know, NPCs, and so I may do that for the next episode maybe. In the meantime, I'm gonna go to old Castlevania this bastard, make him pay. Just got to be careful because they hit extremely hard. And I got it when I get double barred here, huh? Hell with you, monster. You don't belong in this world. So he gave me very, very good item. If I find another one of these, I'll be able to pull my Vampire Killer Shane level 4. I'm just gonna take this path. Cause I haven't done it yet, this be true. Hey old man. Happy to see you too. Crazy bastards, man. They chose they don't like Halloween too much. Chest communion. Yeah, it's a nice effect that you can apply later on to your character. But first, I need to defeat those witches to be able to get the item to open the runes so I can use those, you know. Always love the gothic look of this place, the game. Now here my suggestion is just run forward. Damn you, you old fool. Make you pay. You don't touch the Belmont. What the? A gigantic sound. You ugly brute. Come on. Tell what you got. Shouldn't done that. That's what I should do. Let me get the other one from the other side. Get out of here. The look of this world is amazing. It's always great to remember how beautiful this game is, you know? And how strong the Castlevania vibe is in it. If you don't know this, Castlevania were the true Bloodborne and Dark Souls games of the past. This game has strong, you know, influence from it. Was probably the first true gothic game ever made. Now let's play with this fool. This old man, they're so not. Look at these guys. Oh man. Crazy bastard. Ryle, man. It's not that I hate you, but I don't like to be burned, you know. Now behold my most beloved chest in the whole game. Now seriously, it has a very awesome weapon inside. One of the best swords in the game. And one of the few swords in the game too. The Radiant Swords Hunter. Ludwin's Holy Blade. I don't know, I don't think I'm gonna be using that sword for this character, this playthrough. Well, that door is closed, so let's fast travel. Whoa! Holy shit! You're a bad boy, guy. Scare me like that again. Wasn't expecting this fool being here. Now we're gonna jump into some place. So here is one of those, you know, places that you can make some jump platforming and wow, look at this guy. He did that jump badly. That's why he died. So there's a few items here that I might come back and get. I don't wanna get them right now because I don't wanna make this jump hard for me. But they're not really... Ugh. That's how you wanna make that jump, right there. The way I did it, just walk to it. Don't run, don't roll, just walk. And those items, if I try to get them, they're gonna take me to another path. So I wanna come here first. They're not really too amazing, you know, items. Back to the dream. This time, we're supposed to be awake in the dream. Supposed to be the physical place of it. And we got dull items. Damn it, my controller is running out of battery. I need to charge, just give me a moment. So we got this old hunter. One third of a miracle cord. This one is a very crucial item to unlock the true ending or final boss of this game. So you need to gather at least three of these. And we should light the lamp. What else I'm missing here? Oh yeah, that item. Very important. Small hair ornament. This one you give back to the lady doll. And things will happen. You know what? Let's do it right now. I'm gonna fast travel back to the dream. And then we'll see what happened to her.
Welcome home, good hunter. What is it you desire? What? What is this? I can't remember. Not a thing, only I feel. A yearning, something I never felt before. What's happening to me? Tell me, Hunter. Could this be joy?
I can express how adorable Lady Doll is. Every time I take a glance to her face, it's just, I don't know. She got these beautiful, cute eyes, you know. Anyway, she gave us this, the Tear Stone. It's supposed to be one of her tears, so it's pretty much a sacred item. Once you break it, it becomes a blood gem that it will help you regenerate your HP over time. Thank you, beautiful doll. Now, back to here. This area really makes you think a lot. What did they, you know, the lady doll and the whole workshop can truly be. Why she's just a doll here, but in our dream she's a living being. church workshop. Now we're getting close to fight an unholy beast of the brave fear. Jump there if you can do it. There you are, monster, guarding the door. This time I won't cheese you. Come on, let's fight. Forever, that attack. Shit. Coming up on you, buddy. Damn. Sometimes you don't think that he will reach you when he goes on rampage mode, and they can have a pretty deceptive range with their melee attacks. So I suggest you just, you know, dash backward and wait for him to finish the chain, then attack him. Now this area. The old town gone to hell.
Anaya curses. Anaya to remember. What do you say, friend?
I So back here again. You can buy the item and open that door and come here without taking this shortcut. But what's the point of wasting all that experience points in that key, you know? Numbling, mist. Now this item is a very good item for certain enemies, like the boss in this area. It will prevent, you know, the characters, the enemies from healing. Any enemies that have the capacity of heal. Also players, you know, if you get invaded by some red shit. But we're gonna use it for the boss in this area. Now if you jump here, that's another item. You might be interested to find. Oh no, I forgot to open the door. My god. That means I'm gonna have to go all the way around just to open the door to get, be able to go back there. Stupid me. Damn it. Okay, I guess I can just edit all that out and now we're back. Sorry for my stupidity. It was great stupidity. I suggest you to open that first before you make that jump. Oh man, it's okay. It's alright. Now let's open these gates. Now this area, it has a very tricky thing that if you want to summon people to this area or if you want to play with other players, you need to open all these gates so it will link the connection to be able to interact with other players. And I say this because I always like to do solo my playthroughs in my videos, play the game by myself. That's how you get truly good at the game, playing solo. But I really like to help other players, so. Now these guys. Hey, big one. Yeah. You can get behind him, going around him, but that's the only attack that you need to be really careful. If you stay in front of him, you got a lot of range, so, and reach, so. I like to make them do that attack. You can go and hit them back. But just wait for the right opening. Make sure he won't the attack twice, you know. Come on, big boy. Like that. Hit it twice right there. I'm trying to get a whip on his face because I can do a critical hit on his face and I can do a visceral attack. Critical attack, however you want to call it. We got another giant to deal with. This is the last door you need to open. Now you can interact with all the players. It's all about patience. And the beef shuffle. Okay, so I wanted to do something cool on this Halloween related to what I really love and classic horror and Castlevania. So I just want to wish the best Halloween possible for everyone, and Halloween should be every day of the year.